Fire in the hall.
Fire in the hall, propane.
In times gone by, we were called special effects men. But since the digital age has come about, they've broken it down to visual effects and special effects, which is really digital work, which is done in a lab, and the mechanical special effects, which is done live on the set. You need live elements so that the actor can work with things. And the actor just can't work against a blue screen or a green screen all the time. He won't get the feel for it. We have to match all the elements. Anytime somebody's falling off a building, we create that wind. Everything you see in the air, we will put in the air.
See, this scene required, Sam wanted a lot of pollen in the air, but the problem was that because we came here, it wasn't quite spring yet, we had to look for this stuff. And what we found, the best thing for pollen is actually belly button lint. And we've been collecting this belly button lint now for about 4 weeks. We always thought that New York was just, like you hear a lot of things about New York. What we found is that New York is actually the belly button lint capital of the world. This is about 3 weeks of belly button lint from New York. We hope we have enough for the shot.
Anything that generally will move, we are responsible for. The construction department will build the set, but then it is our responsibility to make that set move.
Come on. Ready and action. He picks up Spidey and he's aware of it. Ready, stop, throw, and hit.
I kind of have a rule of thumb where if it's shot within 15 feet of a 15-foot range, it's pretty much going to be live. Anything past that is pretty much going to be digital.
Go!
Cut!
Somebody! Help!
The fire on this one was almost three times as big as the first one. We shot the first one in New York City, and we were pretty limited on what we can do there, although the fire department was a big help. We did the second one on the back lot at Universal. So it was pretty much, we built the set to burn.
No one in this area other than stunts and effects. Okay.
There's air mortars inside to accentuate the blast with the debris and a little bit of wind. And there's a little bit of sparks coming out with the doors for Sam. And it won't be too noisy. No ear protection inside, but out here we're all fine.
The burning building was a very special set of needs that we had to fulfill to accommodate the shooting crew and to accommodate John and to provide a set that was safe for everybody to work on.
This is the before picture. This is the back lot before it has any of the work we're going to bring to it. No signage, no awnings, no detail of any kind. This is a part of that same block as will represented in the movie with the building on fire. We're going to add all the awnings, the traffic lights, the clocks, the fire escapes, the gratings, the signage. These aspects of New York City will be added in digitally after we shoot our first footage.
E-Mark.
Okay, clearing, and background action, background.
The burning building was a completely different problem. We actually had a building on the back lot that we liked very much. And what we found was that the construction technique on the back lot was fiberglass and wood, and both of those things would have not held up to the intensity of the fire. We actually clad the entire existing building with a duplicate, a skin of the same building made in plaster and backed with drywall. We skinned all the existing surfaces with drywall. We installed metal awnings, metal grates on the windows, and replaced all the wood frame windows with metal duplicates of the windows. And then the special effects team came in and rigged their burning burning bars and burning units and protective shields so that the rest of the building wouldn't catch fire.
What we've got going on here is, this is what we call our fire pan. And what this does is this directs the flames out of the building. Without this pan being on there, the flames would come back into the building and up through the ceiling. And what you can see is, this is just a movie set, so we have to protect the set itself. What we have inside of here, where this pipe is leading to, is what we call a fire bar. It's a piece of 3/4-inch pipe, and what we do is we slot the pipe with a saw, and the propane will enter through here and it will come out and create that fire for us. And what we'll do is we'll set a level that the director likes, and then we'll pretty much maintain that level throughout the course of the night. What these are here, these are our main control valves, and what we'll do is we'll have a preset with the director, and when the director looks at the fire, he can determine what he likes, and then we will adjust the fire to change the height and the configuration of the fire so that all the windows don't look the same, so that it looks like it's hotter, it's maybe not burning as much in one room as in the other one, so it doesn't look like a theme park ride. The principal actors, they don't have a chance to come on the set up until the time we shoot it. And so when they come on the set, we pretty much want to give them a walk through the whole scenario and say, Toby, this is exactly what's going to happen. And then what we'll do is we'll bring up a little bit of fire, make them comfortable. What we're looking at here is what we call a propane mortar. We will fill this accumulator tank with propane, fill it up to, and then we'll charge it with about 125 pounds of air. And then on a cue, as Toby or Peter Parker comes through the door, we will blast this, and what that's going to look like is a little explosion has happened inside the room.
It's scary when you send an actor into a burning building. I mean, the first thought that crosses your mind is, I hope that CG version of him is pretty good. I'm joking, of course.